The basics of Zoho CRM. Hi, and welcome to this video where we'll be covering the basics of Zoho CRM. In this video, we'll take a tour of Zoho CRM and learn about some of the basic elements and functionalities. We'll cover the key terminologies used in Zoho CRM, ways to search records and navigate, the components present in your home tab, and the setup section where there are a lot of options to configure and make CRM your very own. So let's get started. The first screen that you'll see after you log in is the home page available under the home tab. The home tab is a quick indicator of the progress of all of your CRM activities. Besides that, it also serves as a great place to organize your day's work and manage those of your team. It contains components from different modules such as tasks, potentials, dashboards, and so on. You can switch between three types of views here. The classic view, which is the default view that we see right here, this lists three standard components which cannot be edited. It shows the respective users' tasks, events, and records and pipeline by stage. Next is a user's home page. This view allows individual users to customize the home tab for their own account. You can add components that you need, reorder and resize them as required, and view them in full screen. And lastly, the customize home page. This view allows you to customize the home page for users in different roles. The users associated with that particular role will then have this as their default home page every time they log in to their CRM. For instance, you can create a customized homepage for salespeople, including only the components that are relevant to them. Now let's move on to other tabs. Each tab here is what we call modules, allowing you to group all relevant data together. For example, the leads module is where you'll find all the details about your leads as individual records. There are a set of default modules available in Zoho CRM, but you also have the option to create custom modules per your requirement. Let's take a look at a few important default modules in Zoho CRM. Leads are the individuals or representatives of an organization with whom you could potentially have a business relationship. Accounts represent companies or departments within a company with which your organization has business with. And contacts are the people in those organizations with whom you carry out all business-related communications. Deals are the business opportunities you have within an organization or people who generate revenue for your company. Activities help you capture all of the meetings, calls, and tasks that you carry out with the leads, contacts, or accounts. This menu on the top left corner has options to create and manage tab groups. Tab groups allow you to group different modules together and display only the required ones to avoid clutter. On the right, we have the search option. Enter a keyword and you will get search results from all the available modules. The bell icon is for notifications. There are two categories to it. Sales signals keeps you informed about your customers' interaction with your brand across multiple channels, such as emails, calls, surveys, campaigns, etc. For example, you could have a lead with whom a demo is scheduled next week. The same lead visits your website to know more about your products. With sales signals, you'll receive a notification as soon as a lead visits your company's website, and you can identify the exact web pages accessed by your lead, the time spent, and the information your lead is interested in. These details will help you prepare for your demo. In order to understand the feeds notification, let's take a look at a module called feeds. It provides a space where you can openly share your views and discuss matters with team members to speed up the decision process. Additionally, Feeds gives you updates on the important records that you follow, such as who updated a record, what changes were made to a record, etc. If a user mentions you in a message or a comment, or mentions the group that you are a part of, you get a notification here. The plus icon is to add records, and this is the calendar where you can add your events or schedule a call. You can mark yourself unavailable to take calls or other follow-up activities if you'll be out of town or busy at an event. The events you're invited to are marked like this, and you can accept these invitations or decline them. Now let's take a look at one of the modules, leads. In the leads module, this is a list view, which basically is a grouping of records based on a defined set of criteria. For example, the list view has leads that are owned by me. Similarly, there are other such list views, and you can create more per your own individual requirements. The plus icon here is to add new records, in this case, a lead. The Create Custom Lead page displays this layout with a set of fields. The red marking in the text box means that the lead field is mandatory. For example, the last name. Let's fill in some details and save the record to see the records details page. The first section is the business card view, which lets you have a quick glance at some of the important information about the record. You can replace these five fields based on the details that you would want to know first. Click on the Show Details link to view the complete information about this lead. On the top left, we have the timeline, which displays all of the upcoming activities and history of all actions that took place in the record and the data privacy, which will be available if compliance settings is enabled. There may be various other records from other modules that are associated to this lead. All these records are captured here, and these sections are called the related lists. For example, attachments, activities, emails, social interactions, and more. Additional actions can be performed from the top of the page. You can send email, convert the lead into a contact, edit them from here, and click More, which displays all the other actions that can be performed on a record. The Next and Previous buttons help you navigate between the records. If you have a set of leads in a spreadsheet and would like to add them into CRM, you can easily import them as well. Once the records are added, you can switch between three different views: List View, Kanban View, and Canvas View. List View is the default view we saw earlier. Kanban View is a card-based view that displays the data in an organized manner for better comprehension. For example, you can sort the leads based on their status or categorize the deals depending on different stages. This sort of information gives better insights about potential bottlenecks and lets you fix them effectively. Unlike list views, there are no predefined Kanban views available, except for activities, social, visits, deals, and sales inbox modules. The Canvas view lets you completely personalize the way you view records. There is a gallery of design templates that you can choose from or create and customize one. You can make it visually attractive, which helps you find major details that you are looking for without even opening a record. When you have to carry out the same action for a set of records, you can use the bulk actions by clicking the More icon here. Now, you can always increase the number of records that you'd like to see in a page, and it can go up to 100. These records can be further sorted in ascending or descending order. The Advanced Filters here is another very useful feature. With this filter, you can run advanced searches based on the activities associated to the records, such as leads without any activity in the past 2 days, or leads to which emails were sent to yesterday and has the status as opened. If you are applying a particular filter often, you can save it as well. Okay, coming back to the modules, the entire list of modules can be seen here. When there is a big list of modules, you might want to reduce the clutter and see only the tabs that are relevant for a person. For this reason, Zoho CRM has tab groups. It's one convenient feature that groups relevant modules together for easy navigation. For example, a sales rep will frequently work with these modules, so this tab group can be created. Now let's move on to the setup page and understand the purpose behind each function. The functionalities are grouped into categories such as general, users and control, channels, customization, and automation. Let's go through some of the important features in setup. It's always ideal to add your personal information and the details of your company before you begin. So the first thing you would do is go to the general settings and add them in. In addition, you can also configure the fiscal year, business hours, holidays, currencies, and the hierarchy preference, which defines how the data is shared among your CRM users. Selling need not be just about money and targets. You can also have some fun by setting up game scope. Set up trophies and badges, and you can see how people compete and enjoy the work they do. Zia is an AI powered sales assistant in Zoho CRM, who stays on top of everything for you to give you key business information. She can predict the outcome of a deal or a lead, give suggestions, answer your questions, remind you about your activities, and notify whenever necessary. You can also pre-configure questions for which Zia finds the necessary answers whenever you ask. Next is the users and control. Before we check out the details on users, let's take a look at roles and profiles. Roles define who you are in an organization. Based on the role, a user can have access to the data. For example, a sales rep need not access the records owned by a manager. Profiles, on the other hand, define what you can do in your CRM account. It provides and restricts access to the features in CRM. While a sales rep can create and edit records, he may not be given the permission to delete records in the lead and contact modules. These permissions are defined using profiles, and once they're set, you can add a user and assign them to the appropriate role and profile. To comply with GDPR, Zoho CRM provides a set of features under the compliance settings. GDPR, as we know it, is a set of rules defined to provide EU residents control over how their personal data can be used by companies across the globe. In Zoho CRM, you can update these lawful bases to process personal data, secure customers' personal information, get consent from people to use their information and address data, subject rights when an individual needs to exercise them, etc. Territory management can be useful when you have business in different parts of the world and you need to segregate contacts and accounts based on a defined set of criteria. Territories can be based on various factors such as geography, industry, product line, the expected revenue, different verticals, etc. It makes it easy to provide access only to selective accounts for individuals from different teams to work together for a common sales objective. Once the basic setup is complete, you can establish multiple ways in which you can connect with your customers. Channels here allow you to integrate your email, phone, and social media accounts in Zoho CRM. When this is done, all the emails, phone calls, and social media interactions with your customers can be captured in Zoho CRM. You can also track the visitors who are checking out your webpage and offer chat assistance by bringing in Zoho Sales IQ. When the means of communication is vast, customers can reach out to you in various ways, and it's important to be aware of all of them to offer a timely response. Sales Signal sends you real-time notifications of your customer's interaction, be it a comment on social media, submission of a survey, missed call, and whether your email is opened or not. You can know everything. Moving on to the customization category, which is one of the most essential parts of Zoho CRM. One company will not have the same requirements as that of another. Personalizing CRM to suit your business requirements will help manage your business process effectively. Here you have features to create new modules, layouts and fields, personalize email templates with the easy drag and drop editor. Repeated tasks take away from your precious time. The automation and process management features are important in making your tasks simpler by automating a major part of it. For example, the workflow rules allow you to specify the criteria when an action has to be executed. The rule automates the process of notifying a user via email, adding tasks, updating fields, adding tags, and more. You can also schedule any action to take place at a later date or time. Set up assignment rules here so that whenever records are added via import or web forms, you can automate the process of assigning the records to the respective owners. Say, for example, leads from Japan are handled by James. Leads from USA are handled by Mike. Based on the organization-wide record distribution process or round-robin process, you can create assignment rules and automatically assign records to James and Mike. Resolving customer problems in a timely way is also very important. When they're not resolved, it leaves a bad mark on the company's reputation. When the person who is supposed to handle the case couldn't do so, escalating it to another person in the organization's hierarchy is the natural process. To automate this process, you can create a case escalation rule here and specify the criteria of the case that should be escalated if it's not handled in the prescribed time. With the scoring rules feature, you can prioritize leads, contacts, accounts, and deals based on the record properties like fields and customer touchpoints such as calls, emails, social signals, etc. By assigning positive and negative points to each property, points add up dynamically for each record. These scores can help you identify an important lead or deal. Blueprint under process management is one feature that you'll need to configure if you want to streamline your business process. It helps you create an online replica of the business process, which is otherwise discussed in sales meetings and boardrooms. As a simple example, say, after every customer demo, your sales reps are asked to change the status to demo completed, and also need to add the feedback from each customer. Blueprint ensures that these actions are performed and only then the record moves to the next stage. Approval process is another useful feature that helps you automate the submission of records for approval. For example, you want an approval from the manager for increasing the discount for a customer or extending the purchase license of a product. By setting up the right criteria in the approval process, you can make it easy to get your manager's approval. Follow-up actions can also be set up that can be executed when the request is approved or rejected. At the end of the day, it all comes down to managing data. You can import and export data, schedule a data backup, and monitor storage in the data administration category. Additionally, the history of all actions carried out will be recorded in the audit log section right here. And that's not all. You have Sandbox, a testing environment where you can configure all of your settings without affecting the actual data. Marketplace category lists out the various integrations that Zoho CRM has with Zoho's other products. It also lists integrations with external products such as Google, Microsoft, and others. And the developer space has tools for developers to come up with suitable business solutions that can be built and with which the data can be synchronized. It offers a comprehensive suite of developer resources and web services that will help you build these applications. That's all in setup. Now let's recap what we learned about in this video. We learned about the Home tab and the components we can add to it, the various modules and the list views in them, search capabilities to filter records, and the important features available in the setup section. As a next step, we encourage you to log into your Zoho CRM account and browse through the modules and setup functionalities. We also recommend that you add sample records and check out the various items in the records details page. To learn more about the features in setup, take a look at the how-to videos that guide you through the concept and product demonstrations for individual features.